This is one of, if not the most popular RV membership out there, but it is not a money-saving membership. If you think for 1 second that after purchasing your very expensive RV and all the gadgets that everyone recommends that you're done spending money, that's cute.
But seriously, the more you deep dive into this lifestyle, the more research you do, it just seems like, well, now I gotta go out and buy this too. There are so many RV memberships out there fighting for your attention, saying, pick me, pick me. I'll save you money on this. Blah, blah, blah.
Put the credit card down and pay attention, because some of these might not even be right for you. If it's your first time here, welcome to Happily Ever Hanks. I'm Renee, this is Kyle, and our goal is to provide you with as much knowledge as possible so you can get into this RV lifestyle stress-free and with tons of confidence.
KOA, Good Sam, Passport America, Harvest Hosts. These are just a few of the programs we're gonna be talking about in this video, but need not worry, because it's gonna be the Hanks unfiltered version, and why not? It's more fun that way.
Let's start off with one we were recently swindled into buying, KOA Rewards.
If you're not familiar with KOA, Campgrounds of America, it is like one of the staples of the RV industry. I feel like anyone who has ever heard of the word RV thinks of KOA right away.
They're franchised owned, so I guess anyone could pretty much start their own KOA. And there's a lot scattered across North America, even Canada.
Now the KOAs are really great for people with families, lots of kids activities going on. It's a safe, reliable location as well to stay overnight in your RV. So if you're looking for some consistency where you're not exposed to some of those places that are just a little uneasy feeling, well then KOAs should be your go-to. So what exactly is the catch when it comes to KOAs?
They're pretty darn expensive.
I think on average, you can expect to pay anywhere from like 60-ish to 70-ish dollars per night at these KOAs. They take full advantage and mark up their prices considering their competition throughout the RV industry.
So with the KOA Rewards program, you pay $36 a year and you basically get 10% off the nightly rate at these places. Does not count for weekly rates, does not count for monthly, because you're already getting a discount if you do that.
So what about you weekend warriors? I think this is more concerning for you guys who are just popping out for an occasional trip here and there. How does this apply to you? Well, we did the legwork for you. We reached out online and we got some answers.
And there it did say that it includes nightly rates. It could be weekend nights, but if there's any special rates already happening, you can't double dip and use that 10% off. So it's kind of a double-edged sword in the fact that you can't really predict ahead of time whether you're going to be able to always use this discount.
Read the small fine print, the terms and conditions at the bottom. I know you don't want to read it, I don't want to read it, but I read it for both of us. So going forward, don't worry, we'll condense this down as best as we can and help you find those loopholes.
In those terms and conditions, they talk about also allowing you to receive reward points. But let me summarize this and give you a scenario where the KOA Rewards programs might benefit you. I sat down and I did the math for you and I determined as long as you utilize nightly stays at a KOA at least 5 to 6 times per year, you're gonna wash out, basically get the membership price back. After a long travel day in Alaska, we were definitely swindled into this. So this is a tip for you. Don't sign up for any memberships after a long travel day because your brain is just mushy. And this lady who got us to sign up for it, she deserves a raise. She explained it so many times and it sounded like a no-brainer in the moment. We were like, absolutely sign us up for this.
Yes.
But then when we sat down and did the math and we looked at how many times do we actually stay at KOA campgrounds, I looked through our bank statements over the past 2 years and we only overnighted at a KOA twice. So let's just say we stayed at a KOA once in 1 year. We paid $36 to save $6.
It's so easy to be like, yeah, we'll throw the money out there in anticipation. 6 nights doesn't sound like a lot, but I guess according to us, we just don't stay at them that often. So it just wasn't worth the price.
And before you sit there and say, well, what about all those reward points, Renee? You get reward points even if you stay weekly or monthly. Mm-hmm. We would advise you to never pay for a membership just for the reward points.
100%. It doesn't add up. Before we do move on, we want to say, however, if this information is starting to work the brain cells a little bit, bringing you a little bit of value, listen, there are so many others out there that need this information as well. So we ask that you share this with any groups you're part of, maybe Facebook, Instagram, share it with anyone you know that might receive some value from this video. We would appreciate you guys.
Because we're all in this together.
Well, I'm glad we clarified that. Here is a quick tip for you guys that's gonna bring you a lot of value. If you already are part of some of these membership programs, you want to look at the extra perks that come along with these programs. I say that cautiously, however, because going back to Renee's point, you never want to buy a membership in anticipation of the extra perks. They like to use those as shiny objects to get you signed up for, but if you're already part of them and you're enjoying the membership, look into it because you might be missing out on some awesome things.
Yeah, tell them about what you just found out with Costco and Escapees the other day.
Oh, yeah, exactly. We like to rely on Costco a lot in our travels, and Escapees were already part of the program. They offer like a discount with Costco, which is great. So we're gonna take full advantage of that, save some money on the road, which is win-win.
Escapees has been around for a while. It's basically another RV membership program. It offers discounts on RV parks, some of them 50% off, which is pretty cool. Now, something I discovered with Escapees, it is $49 per year, but I looked on their website, and if you are active military, you get it for free.
Don't even have to put money out. You're making savings.
I know, that's
now,
so
that's
cool.
Something you jump on.
But is it worth the $49 if you're really not using the mail service or anything else that comes with it?
I'll talk about a little bit of a personal story with us. We've stayed at one Escapees park that I can remember, and it wasn't really much to write home about. It was just kind of there. It was a safe location, but it just, the upkeep on it wasn't incredible. Now, I don't want to judge a book by its cover. Maybe other parks out across the nation that are involved with the Escapees program are much nicer. However, for us so far, it's all right.
There was also a campground listed on the Escapees site that said, we are part of the Escapees program. We went to that campground to use our Escapee discount, which was 15% off the nightly rate. And they said, no, we do not work with Escapees. So it's a very outdated system.
You go onto the website and you just kind of feel like you're taking a step back into the early 2000s. The website itself just, it's not up to par, I would say. It's kind of hard to maneuver around. Very old school.
Yeah, like I was trying to use the maps to find Escapees RV parks, finally zoomed in, and then every time it clicked a new park, it would zoom back out. And I was like, oh my gosh.
It is an interesting program because it opens up some horizons. They have their own RV rallies that people can join and go meet other like-minded RVers out on the road. Like we said, it has the mail service program. It also has, once again, some of those other discounts like tire discounts, Costco memberships. So I'm just trying to bundle it all into one. Would I say go out and buy an Escapees membership?
Take a look at the website and everything they offer. And if you feel like you can use it to its full benefit, then go for it. But otherwise, listen to what we have to say about the rest.
Okay, enough about Escapees already. Let's get into something that is a close competitor, which kind of piqued our interest right away. And then I was like, maybe not so much. And that program is called Passport America.
You found out something interesting about the 50% off that they offer for RV parks.
Yeah, so that was their big draw to the program, saying a lot of our campgrounds that we were associated with, we will offer 50% off the nightly rate of those campgrounds. I'm like, well, looking more at the fine print, they have something called blackout dates. If you're not really familiar with it, it's during busy times that each individual campground has the ability to say, no, these discounts do not apply. Very much like a franchise where these campgrounds have full control over when they accept these prices and when they don't. So you're looking at holidays, weekends, any busy times, like peak seasons, you can show up to these campgrounds and be like, hey, we got that Passport America. And they're like, no, we're not accepting that right now. So that could be extremely frustrating.
We also heard that the campgrounds are a little bit more run down and they're trying to get more business to these places. So it's not like you're getting these crazy upscale resorts.
Yeah, you gotta think about that. What is the draw for the 50% off? Something has to correlate with that. So most likely you're gonna run into some of the kept under, swept under campgrounds of the industry. Listen, so many other people are out there looking for those similar discounts. So take that into consideration. When you show up to these parks, it might be more crowded. There might be more noise. It just draws everybody and their mother to that place. So that's something else to consider as well.
What does it cost to get this 50% discount on RV parks? It says for 1 year, it's about $44, 2 years, $79, and then it keeps
saving more money the longer you go out. Some people have even paid a lifetime membership, and I read some really negative comments about the program where they're like, I used the program one time because every campground I showed up to, they denied me that 50% off deal. So it's just something to keep in the back of your mind.
Now, some people use Passport America all the time and they love it. And if you're one of them, we want to hear from you down in the comments below. Let us know your experience with the program so we can all
learn from it.
Yeah. Out of all the memberships we're talking about today, this is the only one we have not personally used. So just...
Well, let's move on to something we have used, and we've used it a lot.
Yes.
Good Sam.
We signed up for Good Sam back in 2017, and I'm very surprised by how far it's come since then. They've added on like so many extra things. They're partnered with Camping World and Gander Sports or whatever they're called.
Yeah, something like that. So what are some of the benefits with this program? Well, let's talk about some things we haven't discussed already. Well, they do offer a fuel savings program, which is pretty cool. So if you're on the road and you like to use truck stops, because who doesn't? They're big, convenient, and easy to get to. Well, they'll offer up to 5 cents a gallon off of gas and 10 cents a gallon off of diesel.
That's pretty good. And that is what we used for diesel. We would go to Flying J and Pilots because they have those RV specific fueling lanes, and we would use our Good Sam card to get that discount.
Another thing we never discussed is propane. Good Sam offers you discounts of like, I think 15% at Camping Worlds on propane.
Okay, but I looked at the fine print on this because we have yet to utilize this.
Yeah.
It's at select locations only, and supposedly it's like only on Tuesdays.
Of course it is. Of course it is.
This is what I'm saying is they put the like really good deal right in the front there. Like you get discounts on propane, but only on Tuesdays.
The shiny objects always get us. I fall for them every time, so don't feel too bad. The other great thing is they offer 10% nightly discounts as well.
Yeah, and there's a lot of RV parks that participate in Good Sam.
Yeah.
Now, we don't use Camping World a lot because we full-time RV, so we ain't trying to buy any more camping supplies. But if you're a person that likes to shop at Camping World, they offer discounts there, yada yada. So once again, if you have Good Sam, make sure you're going into the program to utilize all the benefits. Oh, I did forget to say the dump station one is pretty good. If you use their dump station at a Flying J or a Pilot, it's $7 versus $10. And that's not just on Tuesdays. How much do you think it is for the year with all these benefits?
If I had a guess, I would say 55.
39.
Oh, okay. Not too bad.
I swear it used to be $49 a year for 1 year. And now they have listed on their website $39 per year. So I'm not really sure why the price decreased in a era where everything is increasing. They have a Good Sam roadside assistance. We have not used it. But if you get on some forums online talking about their insurance and their roadside assistance, it's very like 50-50 on whether people like it or not.
Let me refer to my notes here because I like talking about credit cards because it's just so fun. I just want to enlighten you a little bit that we had spoke about the credit card before, that Good Sam has a credit card. And I'm all about credit cards, and I can explain. I think credit cards are an amazing tool to help you get cash back for money you're already spending. Just as long as you're not going more into debt. If you can pay it off and reap the benefits, do it. But looking at the credit card itself, they said they offer 5% back for every dollar spent. However, the one thing I did notice in the fine print is they mention all these points expire after 12 months.
Oh.
So if you collected all these and you like to bank them up like I do, you hit that 12-month threshold and you could say bye-bye to all those savings.
Yikes.
So I was like, I'm not all about that.
And you said it's 5% on everything?
It says 5% back at Camping World and Good Sam Family Brands.
Whatever that is.
You could get 3% cash back at campgrounds and gas stations, and then unlimited 1% cash back on everything else. So this ain't a credit card video, but it's just there. Put it in the back of your mind and do with it what you will. Just take this back already.
All right. Harvest hosts. In the beginning, harvest hosts used to just be parking at wineries, and that's why it's called Harvest Hosts. But man, it has grown over the years.
What it is a program that opens the doors to unique camping experiences for overnight stays. What I mean by that is you could go park on a winery, you could go stay at a museum, you could go stay at a church, you could go stay at an alpaca farm. There's so many different varieties of places you can park overnight, and this program kind of brings you to the doorstep of all those places.
Now, Harvest Hosts has many different tiers. But for the sake of this video and this membership, we're only gonna talk about the basic Harvest Host program, the $99 per year membership. All you get is the Harvest Host. Well, let's talk about like the cool parts of the program. You are parking at really unique places like farms and wineries. So after a long travel day, instead of going to like a crowded RV park that's loud and it's kind of not relaxing, you could park like in the vineyards or on a hill overlooking the alpacas or in a restaurant like a brewery parking lot. So now you have a place to eat after a long travel day.
Now here's the catch, however, you're not parking there with anticipation you're gonna have hookups. And hookups are your electric, your water, and your sewer. Most of these places don't have any of those. So you're gonna be boondocking, which means you gotta be self-contained for the night.
This is one of, if not the most popular RV membership out there, but it is not a money-saving membership. Let us explain. It is expected that you spend at least $20 at these locations to support them, right? They're small businesses, most of them, so that's what you would do in order to be able to park at them.
Now, I thought you said that went up to $30.
Well, okay, I'm glad you said that because there have been a few locations recently that in the fine print of the specific spot, they ask that you spend at least $30. Dang, the inflation nowadays.
It's wow, that's a lot. So you're going and paying for a membership that's 100, and then you're having to spend an extra 20 to 30 a night per location. It adds up. So I would say you would have to park at a lot of locations before you would see a return on your money comparing to other typical RV park prices. The cool thing about the program is they have over, what, like 5,000 locations nationwide?
Yeah, yeah.
And it goes across Canada, and I think they partake in Mexico as well.
Yeah.
So that's really nice. So it's definitely a program you wanna look into if you are looking for some unique experiences of like, I'm not really worried about saving money, I'm more looking for lifelong memories.
Yeah, if you have kids and you wanna spice up your overnight by being able to go to a farm, this is the program to look into, but we just wanna make sure that people are not signing up for it to save money. A lot of people use it and make it worthwhile because after a long travel day, you really don't feel like cooking. So you can go support the business where they have a restaurant, or you can get like a ton of fresh farm eggs. You can have a glass of wine at a winery. Yep. So you can really maximize the use and just add to your RV experience.
One last thing we want to mention about the program is once you purchase it, you can't just show up to these places and expect that they have a spot for you. There's an extra layer of communication that needs to be had between you and the Harvest Host member at the spot you're staying for the night. So you have to reach out ahead of time, make sure it's good. There's also length restrictions with these Harvest Hosts. So if you're pulling a 3-axle rig behind you, sometimes you're not going to be able to be accommodated when it comes to staying there overnight.
We run into an issue with this because we are just willy-nilly like figure out where we're gonna stay for the night. So with Harvest Host, it's like we have to plan ahead and we just don't like to plan ahead.
We're more fly by the seat of our pants kind of people. If you're still not sure after all this has been said, are the memberships right for you? Listen, we get it. There are plenty of other secret ways to save money out on the road, and I bet you didn't even know they existed. Click and watch this video next because these money-saving secrets are so good that it feels like you're cheating. We'll see you over there.